YouTube land. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy C Sleazy, and I have tried to record this video 3 times, okay? So hopefully this one, you know, works out, and if you're hearing this right now, that means it does, alright? So what I'm doing in this video is I'm gonna break down my top three favorite builds going into this year. What I think are gonna be the best builds if, and I do mean if, what Wang said about your three-pointer is true. That's one thing that it depends on. And two, if we still get the 99.9 boost, you know, where we get the 4+ attributes, okay? Let's get straight into it. So, the first one I'm gonna show you, which is personally my favorite, simple, this pie chart right here, okay? You can do everything. Honestly, you can do absolutely everything with this pie chart. And the way I'd break it down, excuse me, I'm still trying to get used to this commentary stuff because it's been a minute. But the way I would do it, I'm going up on my driving dunk, up on my close shot, and up on my driving layup. That gives me 16 finishing badges, right? 4 Hall of Fame badges, all right? I'm going mid-range, 3-point, and free throw. 16. Pass accuracy, ball handling, 13. And since this is gold, okay, my playmaking badges are gonna be gold. I'm only putting this up until I get 15. Boom, okay. That's the way I like to make it. You can make it differently. This is just the way I feel. Then you go perimeter, lateral, steal. Look, I'm not saying this is the best build in the game, but this is the best build in the game. All right, look. Look, bro, look at that. That's 4 finishing, 4 shooting, 5 playmaking, and 2. You can break it up however. Now, I know this is how some of y'all are going to make this build, and I ain't mad at you. I kind of like the way it's looking. But me, personally, you know what I'm going to do? You can do that. Or you can even, if you're feeling risky, knock this down to 3, right? And get 2 more shooting badges. But I'm, like I said, it's all up to you. It is literally all up to your play style, the way you play. If you want to be more of a finisher, you know, you can go up here, knock this up, get 2 more, you know? But it is literally all up to you. You can even go up here and fan a little bit just to see what you get, you know, come back down here. Oh, shit, I fucked a lot of shit up right there. Hold on, my fault. let me go fix that, hold on. Alright. You know, but this is, in my opinion, probably the best you'll get. Something along here, you can do that. So, 15, 18, 15. Oh, I fucked up. My fault. Damn, I'm bad at this commentator stuff, y'all. I'm trying to tell you. I am too bad at this commentator stuff. Alright. So, I might just have to cut that out. That's embarrassing. This is what I like. 16, 16, and 15. Okay? Because, you know, your shooting badges, right? You're going to have Hot Zone Hunter, Green Machine, Range Extender, and then you can do something like Catch and Shoot, whatever. Deadeye. Doesn't really matter to me. This is the best way to make it. This build, if you're just going all the way across the board with whatever. Me, I'll do more shooting badges, but like I said, that's just me, okay? This doesn't matter whatsoever. Now, this is where it kind of gets interesting. You can do whatever you want right here, but what I would do, I'm going 6'3". I just feel like 6'3" is the smartest thing to do. I'd do lowest weight for speed. And this is where it gets controversial. Now, if the 99.9 boost is still there and you get the 4+ attributes and it's just like 2K20, that 82 ball handling will go to an 86, 77.3 will go to an 81, 79 mid-range, 83, 81 driving dunk, 85, that's contact dunks. Now that's at 99, okay? So that shit might be gassed. Like, that might be the way to go. And you can do this however you want it, but I can, this is probably the best way to do 82.2, but it's just, I don't know, something about it just don't make me feel right, you know what I'm saying? This, honestly, is probably the smartest thing to do, your 82.2, because it gets you even closer to the driving dunk. So, yeah, but if you go again, it just kills everything, it kills the whole vibe. So, for the sake of this video, we'll go 82.2, and you go slashing takeover. Now, one thing about this build in the demo is the badges are glitched. They don't apply right, at least for me, they don't apply right. So I'm gonna stop this build right here, but what I would do, because you get 4 Hall of Fame contact or finishing badges, I'm going contact finisher, relentless finisher, slithery, and I'll let you, you know, you can do whatever, probably fancy footwork. And then for the shooting badges, you'll get 4 of those as well at Hall of Fame: range extender, high zone hunter, green machine. And what I like to do usually is catch and shoot, just because of my play style, so that's what works best for me. Playmaking is literally all up to your play style and how you play. You even get dimer on this build, and then you have the defensive badges to do whatever you please as well, so it like really all works out. Okay, so that's the first build. Okay, this is my favorite build, and this is probably the build I'll make after I find out if the 99.9 thing is still in the game. So let me get straight on to the second build I'm talking about. All right, and the next build we get into, simple as that, we're going straight into it. Now, last year, the, what was it, two-way playmaking, whatever the hell it was called, I don't really, two-way playmaking finisher, I think. I didn't play 2K20, I hated that game, it was too damn boring to me. That was a very OP build, but I don't think that 66.3 is cutting it this year, and I'm sorry to say. So, we going right up, and this is the my second favorite build, and I'll get to why. I'll get to why in a second, just, you know, wait. So, you make this build, boom, boom, you have 29 playmaking badges just by upgrading those 2 things. Insanity, right? So then you go 3-point, mid-range, free throw, post-fade, and you just do all these, right? You just do all these. You can do it however you want, but I see a lot of people posting this, and I don't really rock with this. Like, there's no way in hell I'd make my player like this, just because I don't feel like it would do right. So what I would do is I'd come down here and get this post hook and take it down to about 9. I come to the shooting and take it down to about 15. Hold on. To about 15. And then I'm taking my pass accuracy, because what, Hall of Fame, I mean, you can leave it there, but I don't really think it's going to make that much of a difference if you do or not. And then you just keep on adjusting them. It's really up to your play style. You got to count the badges that you would use. So are you really going to use, what is that, 7 Hall of Fame playmaking badges? Are you, like, if, I mean, if you are, go for it. If you're doing 7 Hall of Fame playmaking badges, go for it. But I just don't see a lot of people doing that. I honest to God, do not see a lot of people doing that. Now, are you using 5 shooting badges? What? You're using, a lot of people use 4. So, I mean, you can, you know, adjust that. Do you need a post fade? You don't really need a post fade. So, you could do that and then get you some defensive badges. You know, it's all about your play style. That's what I'll be telling people. So, for my playstyle, the way I go, if I wanted 7 Hall of Fame badges, this is what I'm going with. This is easy for me. This is exactly what I'd go with. Because I get the defensive and I get the shooting and finishing about right where I want everything. You can make a little changes here and there, like I said, depending on your playstyle. If you're more of a slasher, maybe swap the shooting and finishing. It's on you. It is your choice, right? So let's go straight to it. You know, don't, this doesn't matter. Built. Now, I make my guy 6'5". Fuck it. Could go 6'6", but then that, you know, hit the 3-pointer. And yeah, it's only about 1, but it, I feel like that still is enough. So 6'5 for me is where I'd put it. and you still have 94 speed. All your stats are still looking insanely good, right? And this is where I might lose some people, but hold on with me. You make him 6'5", and you minimize that weight, that speed is right back, and you get more acceleration. It's not, you're not losing in that situation, and you have a 70 driving dunk, and that's usually what the point is for certain dunk packages. So it's clutch. Now, depending on if you're a shooter or not, you might want to do this. But I say either just keep it how it is, or this if you're more of a finishing. But me personally, I'm just keeping it at 81.5. Go straight into it. Now, this year, I don't think the playmaking takeover is going to work again. I just don't see it working. I could be wrong, though. I could 100% be wrong, and I hope I'm wrong. But me personally, I do not see it working whatsoever. Okay? I wouldn't go with it. If you want to just be good and get good plays, you might want to go with that slashing takeover, because you might even catch a couple contact dunks here and there. I'm not one to tell you, but you actually might, depending on how lucky you are and depending on if it's like last year, okay? Shot creator is another really good one too, if you can make your shots. If you can make your shots, I'm going shot creator. But I feel like the most fun option would be slashing. But again, it's all up to you and how you play, okay? Now for the final build I'm going to be going over, this is what I made at the beginning of last year, and I love the build, but the game just got really boring to me. So I'm going to preface that, because I felt like it kind of got too easy, okay? So let me get straight into the third build. Now onto this third build. I've been looking at it, I've been going over it, and this is what I've come to. You have these two pie charts right here. Very, very, very similar pie charts. Very similar pie charts. Now, you might be asking, C, what you finna do? Let me tell you. This is the build I had last year. This build, and it was goated. I could do whatever I want, like I said. But me looking at it, this build might be the one. This build right here might be the one. And let me break down to you why I think that will be the best build out of those two. First of all, let me tell you, out of those two. All right, you're a playmaking sharpshooter, right? Boom, 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 boom. You can get 27 shooting badges. You can get 21 playmaking badges, right? But I mean, you don't need that many damn playmaking badges. You feel me? That's overkill, right? It's overkill. You don't need that many badges. This is what? Oh shit! Here's that math. Six Hall of Fame and one gold. I don't know if you really need that. So let's do this. Let's bump this down just to six. Just to six shooting badges. Okay. Playmaking. Do you need all those badges? Nope, you don't. You get five Hall of Fame playmaking badges. Okay? Stick with me now. Stick with me. I still have 234 attributes remaining. Now, this is where it splits. If you are a player that is strictly living and dying by the perimeter, I'm letting that bitch spray like Curry, okay? If that is you, I would do this. I would upgrade your defense and everything to do with defense so you can get some good defensive badges. But if you want to be more like Kyrie, where you can go in the paint too, you're not really dunking on nobody, but you can finish in the paint, I'm upgrading more of my finishing. It's all up to your play style. We've been over this, right? So me personally, I like to go in the paint some. So I'm going to do my driving layup, my close shot, you know, all these. Get a couple. But you can't forget about these. You cannot forget about them. That's two bronze badges. That's two silver badges for finishing. This looks good to me. This is how I would build my player. This is exactly how I would build my player, okay? Now, I can understand the debate. You knock this down to three. Straight down to three. Hold on, let me get there. And knock this up to four. I get it. Or you just do that. Yeah. This is what I would do. Now, I scratched what I said earlier. This is what I would do, okay? And we're not gonna sit here and agree on the same thing. But you can go back and forth. You can interior defense. I don't know how much that's gonna matter for my build, but it doesn't give me the badges. Cause I know people on like my videos last year, they pointed this out to me. Oh, you don't have any interior defense, blah 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 blah. Right? But I put all that there and it doesn't give me my badges. But all I have to do is come up here and then boom, I got four defensive rebounding badges. It's all up to how you do it. It is really all up to how you do it. So you get four finishing, 24 shooting, 20 playmaking, and four defensive rebounding. That shit sound pretty good to me. That could be me, though. That could just be me. And, you know, build whatever, da-da-da-da-da. Now, this build, you can't make 6'5". I'm being honest with you. You can't do it. I mean, you can, but I wouldn't do it. 6'4 is debatable, but 6'3 is safe. You don't go wrong with 6'3". Don't expect to be dunking on people, though. Let me just go ahead and say that. This is not a dunk on people build. Now look at this. Look at this build. You cannot tell me this build is not nice as hell. Look at it. Look at those stats all the way around. 86 ball handling. 93 three-pointer. Come on now. And then, like I said, you can do whatever fits your play style when it comes to the takeover badges. But this build is goated if you are a play sharp type build. If you're like, if you're somebody who wants to be able to dribble and break ankles, I said dribble and break ankles, dribble and shoot, this might be the build for you. Or you can go all the way back. I'll give you a twofer right here. I'll give y'all a twofer right here and go this one and upgrade it damn near the same exact way. You can literally upgrade it damn near. I'm pretty sure you can't upgrade it the exact same way. Let's see how it turns out. All right, actually might get some more, whatchamacallit. I mean, I know it's not gonna work out the exact same. I'm not expecting it to, but hold on. Da-na-na-na-na. Yeah, it's not gonna work out the same. Sadly, it's not going to. I mean, maybe if you, nah, it's just not going. It'll change with the way your badges go. I mean, you can probably do 3 and 3, if I had to guess. Yeah, you can do 3 and 3, 24, 21, 3 and 3. But it's literally all up to you, because this is not, you know, this is not gonna give me another badge. So there's no reason in taking that down. So if you go this and you upgrade it, 6'3", of course, because you know you don't want to, you really don't want to drop yourself. I mean, you can, but I wouldn't advise it. But this is strictly a play sharp type build. Just, you can go in the paint with it, but I just don't know, you know, how well it's gonna serve you going in the paint. And you minimize the wingspan. Yeah, it's better dribbling, less shooting, less driving. So I prefer the other build more, but like I said, that's me. But with this one, you do get the slashing takeover, which doesn't really make sense because the other one had more slash, or yeah, whatever. But yeah, this has been the video. Make sure you let me know what you think in the description and all that. Not the, damn, I'm tired. In the comments, let me know what you think. And if you want to see a shooting guard, small forward, power forward, center, builds like that, let me know and I'm at y'all with it. But it's, so far, you know, it's been your boy C-Sleazy and I'm out. Peace.